Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. This is our last World Tech Update of the year, but don't worry, we'll be back in 3 weeks on January 9th from CES in Las Vegas. It'll be a show you won't want to miss. This week, we'll start with retailer Target that confirmed data from 40 million credit and debit cards was stolen at its stores between late November and mid-December. It reported that thieves had accessed the data stored on the magnetic strip through swiping machines that could have been tampered with at the retailer's stores, a practice known as card skimming. The card information that may have been compromised includes the name of the customer, credit or debit card number, the card's expiration date, and the security code, Target said in a note to customers. Target said it's working closely with law enforcement and financial institutions and has identified and resolved the issue. Customers with unauthorized activity are urged to contact the company. We've shown you robots from Boston Dynamics before. Remember Big Dog? Well, now Google owns all of them. The search giant acquired Boston Dynamics, which is the brains behind many of the robots we've shown you on this program, including Big Dog and Atlas. Boston Dynamics is the eighth robotics company that Google has acquired in the past 6 months. One hallmark of Boston Dynamics robots is their human-like balancing ability. In most of the videos, the robots are hit or pushed and are able to maintain their balance. Boston Dynamics is based in Massachusetts, and its customers include all branches of the U.S. Armed Forces, U.S. government contractors, and private sector companies. If you're waiting for the next Microsoft CEO to be announced, you may have to wait a little bit longer. The head of the four-man committee conducting the research said that the team is expected to complete their work in the early part of 2014. He said that the team identified more than 100 possible candidates, talked to several dozen, and focused their energy on about 20. Reuters reported that Microsoft culled the list to about 8. One name that has come up is Ford CEO Alan Mulally. And one interesting bit of information is that I requested an interview with Mr. Mulally at CES, and a PR rep said he won't be attending because of his schedule. For us here at World Tech Update, the biggest story of the year is one that's indicative of a changing market, Steve Ballmer's retirement. Yes, there were big product launches and other tech scandals, but Ballmer's retirement isn't just about Ballmer. It's about a tech titan, Microsoft, that has lost its ability to make what customers want. Windows Phone has gotten good reviews, but only has enjoyed marginal success. Windows 8 isn't enticing consumers, and the company's Surface tablets are nothing short of a disaster. CES is coming up soon, and I could remember just a few years ago sitting with thousands of other journalists and listening to Bill Gates. Then Microsoft lost the CES keynote. Then they left CES altogether. First, we all thought it was a bad sign for CES, but it continues to be a strong show, so it seems more like a bad omen for Microsoft. The company's next CEO will be charged with the big task of making products that customers want and by completing Ballmer's vision of turning Microsoft into a devices and services business. We've produced a number of year-end videos that take a look back at some of the biggest tech stories of 2013. You can find them all on Network World's YouTube page at the link below. They include a look back at Apple, Microsoft, tech news in general, gaming, and robotics. I hope you enjoy. And we'll end our show on a fun note. Did you know that many of you are carrying a Christmas karaoke machine in your pocket? It's Google's Christmas-themed Easter egg. Go ahead and do a Google search for Let's Go Caroling, and after a few seconds, you'll be presented with 5 holiday classics. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. As we head out, we'll leave you with some shots from our year-end reports. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year. We hope to see you in 2014 when we kick off the year at CES in Las Vegas.